In John chapter 6, we have one of those amazing responses of Peter. It begins, however, with a miracle. One of the most amazing miracles in the New Testament, where Jesus takes 5 little loaves and 2 fish and feeds thousands and thousands of people. After the miracle, great crowds were following, and Jesus stopped and kind of confronted the crowd and said, you follow me because of the loaves. You follow me because of the food I'm giving to you. And he began to describe himself as bread sent down from heaven. And he said, if you eat of me and drink of me, you'll have life. And they couldn't understand this. And of course, Jesus was talking about a personal, intimate relationship with him, not religion, not feasts, not festivals, not just signs and wonders. And the Bible goes on to say that they saw this as a hard saying, and many turned back and didn't walk with him anymore. And here's where we have the statement by Peter, because Jesus, and I think it was very serious, he turns to the disciples and says, do you wish to go away also? And it was Peter who spoke up. And he said, Lord, where would we go? You alone have the words of eternal life. And we've come to know that you're the Christ, the Son of the living God. And, you know, sometimes in our Christian walk, things get hard and other people stop following, and there's criticism and there's difficulty with our faith. And I believe at that times, Jesus might whisper to you or to me and say, hey, do you wish to go back? And I ask myself many times, you know, back to what? What do you go back to once Christ has called you to himself? Back to the bar, back to the drugs, back to the party life, back to a life that's all about yourself? Listen to Peter again. He goes, Lord, where would we go? You alone have the words of eternal life. And I submit to you that that's so true. There's no going back. There's nothing worth going back to. Jesus is the only one who has the words of eternal life. And we've believed and come to know that he is the Christ, the Son of the living God. Listen, there's no going back.